Welcome to MCN. Now, we can't start talking about this new Tiger Sports 660 without first tipping our hat to the Trident 660, which is its naked sibling. Now, that is a very, very good bike, and it's been a huge success for Triumph, and deservedly so. You know, it's very affordable, it's very easy to ride, it's very exciting. And it's a bike that appeals to all kinds of riders, whether you're new or experienced, which is quite a trick. Triumph have taken that winning formula to create the Tiger Sport 660. So what do you call this bike? You could call it a tall rounder, you could call it a sports adventure. In my mind, you could even call it the fared Street Triple 675 that we always wish Triumph had built, but never did. In simple terms, the Tiger Sport 660 is basically a Trident with a fairing and a big tank. Now, it's going to be gunning for some big hitters in this category of bikes. So you've got the Yamaha Tracer 7 and the Kawasaki Versys 650. They're the main two. But not only is the Triumph more powerful, it's kind of more of a complete package with zero chinks in its armour. That sounds great, doesn't it? But it is slightly more expensive than those two bikes, not by much. Also on a PCP deal, there's not a lot in it at all, but you do get a really nicely finished bike for your money and lots of toys as standard. First of all, you get a really nice little dash. It's a LCD and color TFT mix, which has got everything you need on it. Although it could do with an outside temperature gauge, not that that's important, but when you're touring, you go somewhere nice, it's always nice to see how hot it is compared to where you've just come from. There's two riding modes, traction control that you can turn off, ABS, LEDs, self-cancelling indicators, an immobiliser, twin piston Nissan calipers, a span adjustable brake lever, Michelin's superb Road 5 sports touring tyres, and a hydraulic rear preload adjuster, which is really useful on a bike like this, which even some more expensive tourers haven't got, like Suzuki's GSX 1000 GT. The handlebars are wider, they're taller, they're further towards the rider, the foot pegs are lower than the Trident, so that all adds up to a really comfortable riding position, really natural, really nice to spend time in, really comfortable. Even for a really tall rider like me, I'm 6 foot, and it was just so spacious, which is quite a trick on a mid-sized bike like this. It's really slim and well-balanced and manageable as well, which is just great in all conditions. The fuel tank size is bigger than the Trident's. It goes up from 14 litres to 17.2. And during our ride at its world launch in Portugal, we saw an indicated 51 mpg and the reserve light came on at about 160 miles. It also has a really nice tall 7-way manually adjustable screen, which is really easy to use on the move with one hand. It's quite effective, but as we've said many times before, on really tall road bikes like this with quite vertical screens, you can get a lot of wind buffeting and it can be quite noisy. The Tiger Sport's 80 bhp 3-cylinder engine is identical to the Trident's, which itself is a rework of their fantastic old Daytona 675 lump with a shorter stroke and a bucket load of new components, including lower first to fourth gear ratios and a higher fifth and sixth. Valve check intervals are every 10,000 miles and a 46 bhp A2 license restriction kit is also available. Because that engine is derived from a supersport bike, it's no surprise that it's exciting and it's revvy. There's lots of performance there. And in actual fact, it's got an equivalent power to weight ratio as the Honda NT 1100 we rode recently at its launch. So despite being a small bike, it punches well above its weight. But crucially, that power is really easy to manage. It can be as docile or as exciting as you want. And that's what's been the key to the Trident's success. So that power delivery is nice and smooth. It isn't overwhelming or hard to control. And the ride-by-wire throttle is light and accurate. There's loads of torque all the way through the revs, so you don't have to change gear much. And at 70 miles an hour, it purrs along at 6,000 RPM. It handles beautifully, as you'd expect from a Triumph. Steel rather than aluminium is used for the frame and swing arm, which is longer, which keeps costs down, but the Tiger is still light and agile, The steering geometry is faster to counteract that longer swing arm, and there's 30 mil more suspension travel. The upside down shower forks and shock are basic, but they're perfectly set to give the best mix of ride quality, cornering control and stability. It doesn't just handle well for an affordable all-rounder, it flows through corners with the best of them. And in actual fact, it reminds me a lot of one of the most underrated handling bikes you can buy at the moment, which is actually quite a cheap bike, Honda's CB500X. It handles very similar to that. It belies its spec in a lot of ways. You can push it really hard. The harder you push the Honda and the Triumph, actually, the better it feels, and you've got loads of grip, loads of confidence, and it's just a joy to throw through corners. The front end's got loads of feel. That's probably the best bit. It's very, very stable, and despite having those really low pegs, I never got them scraping through any corners. The Tiger Sport is very, very hard to criticise, but there's one thing. Because it's such a great all-rounder, because it feels so complete, because it feels like a bike that is a lot bigger and a lot more expensive, there's one thing now that's quite conspicuous by its absence, and that's cruise control. So when we're on the launch and we're riding along the motorways, it's so relaxed. You just think, you go for a cruise control button that's not there. So that's a real shame. And a lot of people too would like a center stand, which it hasn't got. But there are a lot of accessories available, as you'd expect from Triumph, including a quick shifter, heated grips, and touring goodies, including panniers, a top box that takes two helmets, and a 25 mil lower seat option. So to sum up, Triumph's Tiger 660 works so seamlessly as a sporty, easy to ride all-rounder. You wonder why it's taken Triumph this long to make it. And when I was riding it, I couldn't stop thinking this. Just how great would a street or speed triple version be?